Hey everybody, today I have a really, really cool tutorial for you. It's this really nice holiday inspired tutorial and I used it using one palette, which is the CoverGirl Eye Brightening Shadow Palette, and it looks like this. And as you can see, it is 705 Vivid Greens, and I really, really like this palette. I really, really enjoyed this colour right here. It's my favourite colour in the whole palette. So yeah, that is what I use in this tutorial. So if you have any kind of colours that correspond with these ones, so a dark purple, a more lilac purple, a pink, and a highlight colour, then go ahead and grab those and watch this tutorial, and I hope you try this and look out, because I really like it. I think that it's a really good holiday wearable tutorial. And also, if you wanted to turn it into nighttime, all you have to do is smoke it out with the eyeliner and just put false lashes on and put a little bit more gloss on and stuff like that. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy this, and I'll see you all very soon. So first of all, what I like to do is I moisturize my face with oily, and then I come back to my foundation. And I don't use a full foundation, I use a tinted moisturizer, but I make it myself. So I use the G Matte Mousse by Maybelline in the colour Cocoa, and I mix it half and half with E45 cream or oilatum cream, whichever one I have at the moment, at that moment in time even. And then I dot it around my face just with my fingers, about that much, and then I blend it into my skin. So after I've blended that into my skin, I like to take my concealer, and I use the Rimmel Hide the Blemish concealer. It looks like this, and this is in the colour Natural Beige. And I know that this is a lot lighter than my skin tone, but I don't use it on my own. This is what it looks like. It's very, very light for my skin tone, but I do not use this on its own. I use it in conjunction with my Sleek Hide It concealer. It looks like this in the number 3. So first of all, I put on the lighter shade, and I put it just in the hollows of my eyes. So just there. And then I like to take the Sleek one and just put it over the top. And then that way, depending on the my skin tone throughout the year, and because it does change, it gets darker in the summer obviously and then lighter in the winter, so depending on that I can switch up how much of the Sleek I put on and how much of the Rimmel I put on. So then I like to just blend it in with my finger. So that's what we've got at the moment, and I know it looks a bit chalky, but once I've blended in my face powder, it'll all blend in, and that's what we're going to do next. And I use a flat top kabuki brush. This is the e.l.f. powder brush, and I use it with the Estee Lauder So Ingenious Multi-Dimension Powder in the colour Cool Cinnamon. And mine's all broken up, but just so that you can see, this is what it looks like. That's the colour. And I just take it onto my brush, tap off any excess, and then I pat it under my eyes first. Do the same with the other eye. And then I go around my face and just blend in the powder. So that is what we've got in the end, and then I go ahead and fill in my eyebrows. So I'm going to go do this off camera because I'm not that well at explaining it. Okay, so now into the makeup tutorial. I've already applied my primer, and I applied e.l.f. eyelid primer all over my eye up until the crease. If you want to go above the crease, then you can go ahead and do that, but I usually just take it.
So once you've applied your primer, you want to take a cream shadow, and I'm using this shadow by Technic, and it's just a shadow stick, and it is a really nice kind of goldy champagne colour.
It's really, really nice, and it's just going to add a bit of like shimmer to our eye. So I'm just going to apply this by the base of the eye,
and then I'm going to blend it upwards just with my finger. So next we're going to go on to the eyeshadows, and I'm going to take my Vivid Greens palette, the one that I showed you in the intro. It's the CoverGirl Vivid Greens, and this is what it looks like. It's got these gorgeous colours, and we're going to take this pink right here first. I'm sorry about my nails, I've just done them and they are a bit messy, but I will fix those. So we're going to take that pink and we're going to put it in the inner corner. And also take it onto the lower lash line. Then we're going to do that to the other eye as well. What we're going to do is we're going to take the lightest colour, which is in the pack, which is this this like pinky white colour, and we're going to take it onto a shader brush like this one. And then we're just going to put that as our highlight. Just pat it on. And then blend it out. After we've applied the highlight colour, we're going to go into the lid colour. And we're using this sort of grey-purple colour. And I'm going to take that onto a fluffy brush. And we're just going to apply this all over the lid. Now we're going to take the darkest colour in the palette right here, and we're going to be using a crease brush, and we're just going to take that onto the crease brush, and then we're going to put this into the crease. So make the outer V shape and then you want to bring it into the crease. And then we also want to take that colour onto the lower lash line as well. So I know that looks a bit crazy at the moment, but we're going to blend that out, and we're using a fluffy blending brush like this. This is just my number 7 eyeshadow blend and contour brush, and we're just going to blend out that harsh line. So after you've blended that out, I like to add a tiny bit more definition into the outer V area. So I'm going to take a black onto the same contour brush that we used before, and I'm just going to add a tiny bit of black just to the outer edge. And then again, we're going to blend that out. So there we go, that is all for the eyeshadow. I'm now going to apply my eyeliner and my mascara. And for eyeliner, I'm going to be using the e.l.f. cream eyeliner. The black one that looks like this. And this is really, really good because it is waterproof, so it lasts on your waterline all day. And then for my mascara, I'm going to use the Maybelline Colossal Volume Mascara. So I went ahead and applied my my mascara and my eyeliner, like I said. And then I also applied my Sleek Sheer Cover Blush in the colour Rust. And it's this really nice colour. I really like it. And yeah, that is about it. Go ahead and apply whatever you want onto your lips. I'm not a really big lip person, so I would just put on some lip gloss, and that's
some clear
it.
Lip gloss, or some lip balm, and
so
that's
yeah,
about
I hope
it.
You guys enjoyed this tutorial, and I'll see you all soon. Bye. You like it rough, and I give it rough, and start to pull your hair, cause ecstasy's your destination, and I'ma take you there. Tell me a secret, baby. Tell me something that nobody else knows. You don't think about it just soon as it goes. Tell me.